Jay Shrek.
James.
In Winslow, Arizona. We're not standing on the corner, are we, James?
No, we are in a cemetery.
Because of why?
Because we are trying to find Earle Marion Cundiff's grave.
Now, Earle Marion Cundiff was well known for owning the Apache Death Cave in Two Guns, Arizona. Now, he became embroiled in a land dispute with a gentleman named Indian Miller. Indian Miller went to his home at Two Guns, Arizona, and shot him down in cold blood, but was acquitted. So when they buried Earle right here, it said specifically, killed by Indian Miller. This enraged Miller, and he desecrated this exact tombstone. The city of Winslow decided it was a public nuisance, so they had killed by Indian Miller taken out of this area right here. Even though the truth was, he was killed by Indian Miller. Or was he really killed by the curse of the Apache Death Cave? And that's just one of the stories we're going to get into as we unravel this mystery of the most haunted cave in the state of Arizona called the Apache Death Cave. You're not going to want to miss this. Well, we're back at the Apache Death Cave, and it's getting ready to be dark, and we're not, you're going to yell out, Skinwalker! Are you going to yell that out, James?
We'll see.
Because this is going to be creepy, and we'll be here at night. Let's go to the murder house.
Sure thing.
Let's do it. Sun's starting to set, and guess what? We're getting ready to go dark. Now let's take a walk real quick into a place a lot of people don't know about. They think the Apache Death Cave is just the Death Cave, but there's a lot more to it than that. One of the parts of the curse was that Indian Miller came into this very house, which we call the murder house, and killed Cundiff in cold blood. He walked right through this door and shot Cundiff in cold blood. Cundiff didn't even have a gun, but Miller was acquitted. But the curse then went to Miller, because then his daughter died in a car wreck. He was attacked by a cougar. He got bit by a gila monster, and he finally left because he got cursed. But he's not the only one. That's just the start of the curse. Anyone that spent any time in this area, in this property, has dealt with the curse. You know, this place is absolutely incredible. You know, one of the things they say, because now remember, we're in Navajo, Apache, and Hopi land, basically where all these cultures mixed. And one thing they say you never say out here is what, James?
Skinwalker.
Skinwalker! I'm more afraid of that than I think I am in the Apache Death Cave, James.
Oh, that was good.
Well, it's getting to be dusk. And me and James are getting ready to go into the Apache Death Cave. James, what do you think, man?
Well, I think this is going to be an interesting night.
You're not, like, big into this, are you, as much
I'm really not. I'm not. It's my least favorite thing we do, but it's fun.
Well, you know, so I, you know, and maybe I make excuses because I just enjoy it, but, you know, I think part of history really does evolve the other side. I mean, and that's why, you know, we just don't do ghosts. I don't even consider myself a ghost hunter. But I do think that when we talk about the history of these places and why something would be cursed, you know, you need to go see if it's really cursed or is that just bullshit, you know?
I agree. I mean, I'm fine with experimenting with it.
You know, one thing that I can say is that as we went into the different places today, the curse part, you know, was it just bad luck, bad decisions, bad choices, you know? So Indian Miller, he gets acquitted immediately, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then because Cundiff's grave said killed by Indian Miller, he desecrated the tombstone when he was killed by Indian Miller, right?
All accounts say that he shot him in the house we were just in over there, and got off on it, and then decided he was going to go make sure that grave didn't say it or something.
Well, you know, a lot of people, though, they think that the Indian death cave is because of all the Apache that were killed in this cave, that's like part of the, you know, why it's cursed. But, you know, the real ghost would be the caretaker in around 2000 that killed himself here, right?
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
Cundiff, who died on this property,
yeah.
Right?
There's always reports of the little girl people see.
You know, well, the little girl, I believe, from the reports that I saw, was Miller's daughter died in a car wreck.
Yeah, you had said that earlier. I just keep seeing, like, on Facebook and all the paranormal sites, the postings about, like, seeing the little girl out here.
So, we're going to try to communicate with them. We're going to see if there's something down there. We're going to see if they're, you know, if anything comes. But, you know, a lot of times we've always went down there, and we've never been down at night. I mean, even though the cave's dark, we've never been down at night. We've never been to this location at night. I felt it was important that we got out here at night to really feel, you know, what this was like. Because, you know, I mean, I go back to something that you don't seem to have much of an issue with, and that is skinwalkers.
Yeah, I guess because, I mean, it's not my culture, so I don't see, like, them having any reason to bother me. That's, like, a very, like, indigenous culture's story.
So you don't think they're going to touch us?
I don't know, man. I've seen a bunch of stories where, like, that one cat from the I Won't Go Into This Mountain Alone at Night thing, he said he ran into one on the road.
Oh, he did? I didn't hear that.
It's towards the end of that video. He talks about being, like, and what he assumed would be, like, a skinwalker. His dog got scared, hit under his truck when he pulled off the side of the road off the highway. So we'll see, man. I don't know.
The one way is we're not going to have these experiences if we don't go out and see, right? So one thing is we're going to go down there, and we're going to see what's down there, and we're going to see if we can't get some of these spirits to come stalk to us. And like I said, this time I'm not really looking for the indigenous culture as much as I am the people that were the caretakers of this land, the owners of this land, that are actually, the history is that they were cursed.
Well, and by that theory, I think we'll see them when we come out of the cave tonight.
Well, it will be interesting to see how this thing really goes down. You know, one thing that I'm real curious of, people don't realize the amount of serial killers that go up and down 40 Highway.
You always bring that up right before we go in this cave.
Well, I mean, one of my biggest fears, seriously, about the Apache death cave
is
that what I meet or who I meet when I come out here, right? Because there's a guy here when we came here who kind of mysteriously left, right?
Yeah.
He's by himself. This wouldn't be a fun place to go by yourself. Not that somebody doesn't go here by themselves, but this wouldn't be the place to go here by themselves. I mean, you know, so it's going to be really interesting and intriguing because a lot of people come here. At one time when we first came here, nobody came here, right?
Yeah, when you started coming here and then you brought me along for the next time, it was like halfway through getting out of the cave, and we ran into some people.
So, I mean, there was a motorhome just pulled out. No, is that a fire? I mean, it's a fire. What the hell is a fire truck doing out here? Well, I tell you what, I think it's almost time to go down. It's getting dark. Hopefully the skinwalkers are coming out. Hopefully the serial killers will stay on 40. And really, one of my bigger fears is just what you're going to meet when you come out of here, right? And it's not paranormal that scares me. It's the, you know, it's
the real
people.
I'm always far more concerned with people.
But, so, hey,
I think you need to come along with us. Are you ready to go?
Yeah, if you find this camera, we're gone. So we did meet a skinwalker.
Oh, man.
I'm the token skeptic, remember?
Well, let's go down the Apache Death Cave.
All right. Maybe we'll see you guys later.
I hope. Now I do.
Yeah? Okay. I got video. You gotta turn your mic on for me.
Let's sync this together. Check, check, 1, 2, check, check, 1, 2.
Yep. We're live.
You know, one thing about the darkness is it does get a little creepier. You know, we didn't check that building to make sure somebody else wasn't up there.
No.
I'm gonna check my truck real quick one time so I don't have
I'm doing a snake check.
There goes nothing. Skinwalkers.
Yeah, I know you are. I'm gonna say that I saw just the other day no one got eaten by a skinwalker when they were down here.
Yeah, they didn't yell skinwalker. Skinwalker! Yeah. They didn't do that, right?
They did. You were correct.
Man, you can smell it already.
Oh, yeah. The cave is very distinct.
Yeah, but you got a camera on the back. Well, the only thing is, I'm not going to get it out by the time. This is more for on the way out than the way in. You said you weren't gonna get scared.
Yeah, it's like the whole nighttime deal is a lot different as far as I can't see a thing with no natural light.
You know, they used to sell the Indian skulls down here, you know, out of this cave. And if that legend is true, I mean, that is. If there's ever a reason why anything should be haunted, that would be reasoning, wouldn't it?
You know, yeah, I guess that I would put us in the category of crazy white guys messing with stuff.
Yeah, but you know what? If you don't go see this stuff, you don't know.
That's true. I'm going to throw that out there as the truth as well.
It's a lot more quiet in here than I remembered it being before. Maybe
it's... Yeah, without wind. I didn't notice that last time.
Yeah, I was up there.
I know it was. I didn't notice it. Well, the cool thing... Oh, wow. I don't like that.
Don't even look. If you look up there, you won't go in. If you realize how shaky the ceiling really is, you probably wouldn't go in.
Probably true, man. I like this. I forgot about the dead. Or is it gila?
you know. I'm trying to think it was...
Somewhere we are putting.
I think, man, there's no... There's usually a breeze blowing through here.
Yeah.
There's nothing.
I'm just waiting. You turn this light off, and all of a sudden we'll get this, like, really distinct breeze. It's about to freak out.
Well, you know, one thing I can say, though, James, is...
What do you say?
You, at least you're luckier that they ain't going to sneak up from behind.
Well, when they get you, I'm on my own anyways.
Yeah, but while they're eating me, you'll have a chance to escape. And I'm going to tell you to go ahead and go. Yeah. No, that's bullshit.
No, I'm going to stay for you, dude.
Kind of a weird buzz.
Yeah, I got it. My body got a little warm. Well, that's scary.
I know, I was like, what is the...
People have been coming in here where you didn't used to be, and I don't know if that's good or bad. And I don't know, honestly. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
That's right where I saw the weird light last time I was down here. Right in that, like, crevice behind us.
Okay, so if there was ever anything in here, and I'm not saying there is or there isn't. Well, I'm feeling the breeze. It could be from the outside. I mean,
well, there's a vent down there somewhere.
That does go through somehow. I don't know how.
Had you seen people actually made it all the way through?
No. Dude, because I'm never riding with all. I'm 110 pounds. Skinny as a rail. I went as far as a person other than a small child could go. I see my chest through the last bit of hole I could find in there.
Yeah, the Apache Death Cave. It never disappoints.
Pretty cool down here.
It hasn't yet. So. I don't like the light going out.
And this is what's behind you here. Remember the last time I was yelling at you? There's natural light.
Yeah, that was it was natural light. Let's do it. Well, maybe there was.
I think I sat right here last time. This is exactly where I sat last time.
Well, let's get some natural light going. And let's, you're not going to be able to see me. We'll sit down. We'll do kind of like we did down at Fish Creek.
All right.
And we'll take a... Take a chat and we'll turn this light on and off.
Is your light on? You want me to kill mine?
The only light in the cameras. Yeah, let's do this. Go ahead and hit it right there and we'll kill yours completely.
I like it.
Okay. Is anybody down here with us? Is there a coward down here named Indian Miller? He shot an unarmed man in cold blood and then desecrated his grave when he only told the truth. I can see you being pissed off about that, but you know, whether you had land disputes or lease disputes or whatever it might be, I can't see that being a reason. And you know, I didn't know Cundiff. Maybe he was a terrible man also. But, you know, to kill him in cold blood, that's pretty unbelievable. And I tell you what, if there ever was a curse, you've got it, or you had it. I'm sure you're gone now. But are you here with us? Do you have the balls to come back and talk to us? I feel like something's coming. I can't see him being down here with you, if there are Apaches down here. I can't see him being down here with them. I mean, I couldn't see that. And maybe that's the reason that... After what he did to them, selling their bones and their skulls. I mean, my God. There would be ever be a reason that you wouldn't want to be down here with those guys.
Yeah.
Right? How about the caretaker who killed himself in the trailer? Is he down here? Are you pissed off we're down here? Because you did a great job of keeping people out of here. And now people come in here and disrespect you. How do you feel about that? Are you down here with us? Look at that miss. See that miss with the light? Is that miss?
I don't know. I can't.
Can you see it? Man, that looked like miss staring up.
It could be.
Okay, what's the blue light behind me? You see that? What the hell is it? See the blue light? Because I've got the screen open.
I don't.
See that?
It's not physically behind us.
You see a blue light back there? Seriously.
On the screen?
Yes.
Let me see.
See, it's behind me. See how the screen, I've got the screen pointing at me.
Oh, yeah. That's really creepy. I don't like that at all.
What is, do you see anything back there?
That's what I'm saying. Is it's not physically back there.
Holy shit, it's almost, look at that.
I see it.
Holy
thank you for letting us be in your cave. I'm not here to disturb you.
Get your camera and shoot this lens. Shoot my screen.
Okay.
Shoot that screen. You might have to get to the other side.
Oh, it moved.
Holy shit.
It disappeared when I started trying to shoot it.
Well, move your... You might be blocking it. Okay, that's...
That's bizarre.
That's weird.
That was really cool. There it is.
Okay, now get it. But you gotta come around. Can you come around?
Well, I can't see anything, so I have no idea where I'm walking. It's creepy.
Can't be. Is there a reflection it could be?
Yeah, I mean, it could be any number of things. I have no idea what it is, but it is not visibly in front of me.
Well, he was.
Well, that's fine.
I mean, I can't... Well, he's too coward to come down here, right? Because the Indians would kick his ass and he'd sold his skulls.
Well, I mean, I would definitely be bitter if I was a victim of some kind of tragedy and then you sold my remains.
Dude, go down that right there. I'll stay here. I won't leave.
Dude, you're going to leave.
I'm not leaving.
I'm going to go down here and you're going to leave again.
How do you know that?
Because you did it last time.
Well, how do you know I'd do it again?
Because that's what you're trying to get done.
Well, I want to see if they come. They like you.
They don't.
They do too. Every time you go down there.
Well, you know.
Go way back there.
Dude.
I'm still here.
Yeah.
that's fine.
I haven't seen girls go back there, so it's not that big a deal. So many people come back here anymore. That's creepy though.
I'm gonna drop my pack and you're gonna leave, so give me a second.
Sorry, I shouldn't have. How do you know that do that?
Because you really want me to be down here by myself. Which is fine. If my backpack's gone, I'm gonna be a little nervous.
Well, where's it gonna go if I don't take it?
That's what I'm saying. Then all of a sudden my skeptic side goes away and I'm like, oh shit, just like in the jail.
Well, you gotta get practice for the jail.
Yeah.
Because we're staying in that thing by ourselves. Each of us for now.
I am not.
Yeah.
I am not.
We're doing it. I'm locking in. He ain't getting out. I'm not worried about people coming up behind me. See, I'm not. One good thing is, I don't think a person's gonna sneak up in here without
us
hearing.
All the way back.
No, I didn't leave.
Oh, that was scary. I was like, oh, again. Well, I went all the way back there again. It's pretty cool, man. I like it back there.
Go back up. Stay here while I go up here. Just for like 5-10 minutes. I'll be right there in that one opening. I will be. Stay back in here.
Highway's creepy.
Stay back in here, and then... Yeah, just for a little bit. Call the little girl.
She'll be up here, dude. She's up by that house we were at right now.
Little girl, you in here?
What's that?
Where's the little girl?
We saw when we came out here when we were in the cave is, you know, there's fingerprints on my glass, and I don't remember there being any fingerprints on my glass.
Yeah, you're right.
I mean, I don't touch my glass.
No.
I mean, this is mine. I'll take all this right here, but I don't touch the glass. So somewhere, sometime when we were in here, somebody was looking in the truck.
Well, that's lovely. Very, very comforting. There you go.
See, you think it's the creepy stuff. And
there it is. Yeah, nice. That's scary.
Yeah, it definitely wouldn't have touched my glass. I would have, you know.
Here, let's look at my window while we're at it.
Oh. Right there on the right there.
What the hell is. And you wouldn't, I mean.
No, I don't do that. That's funny.
Because you know I'd shoot you.
Exactly. No, that's exactly what.
That's why I know you didn't do it.
I would hear about it many times over.
Now, this is ours.
That's us. That's getting in and out of the truck. But that's funny, dude. Creepy.
That's crazy. It's an Apache death cave. That's what you expect. You can't see anything. It's
pitch black without light, man. Like, even the slightest light.
What the hell was that? Did you hear that?
Yep. I'm hearing noise now.
Okay. Are they coming out now? Or what's up?
I gotta chill.
You know what we look for now?
What?
Aliens.
Aliens.
Well, I mean, wouldn't they come by the crater crash? Seriously?
Maybe. I don't know what aliens do, but yeah.